The Unified Multiaxis Toolpath in Mastercam can perfectly replicate the behavior of morph, parallel, along curve, and project curve toolpaths. But that's not all Unified can do. None of the toolpaths I just mentioned have ever been able to create cuts along a surface's flow lines. Flow line motion has always been handled by the Multiaxis Flow toolpath. Multiaxis Flow is one of the older multiaxis toolpaths in Mastercam and is still widely used by many. However, Multiaxis Flow is built on a different platform than Morph or Parallel, so it doesn't have all the same options and tools. The surface pattern type in Unified can create cut patterns from the UV flow lines of a selected drive surface. We can now take advantage of Mastercam's modern tool axis control and collision control options on a flow line cut pattern. For example, let's make some flow finishing motion on the blade faces of this shrouded turbine. In its current state, the blades are made of a single surface. To make programming easier, we can isolate the blade faces from the leading and trailing edges of the blade. Create a series of dynamic points at the edges of the blade face. We'll use these points to generate an automatic spline. Now we can launch automatic spline. To generate the spline, we must select the first point, the second point, and the final point. Automatic spline will automatically select all the points in between. In prior releases of Mastercam, this was the end of the automatic spline function. The resulting spline was final, and any desired changes would need to happen in a new session of the function. In Mastercam 2023, we have the option to add or remove points in the panel, which is great in this case because we have an errant point on the wrong side of the blade. Now that we have two split lines, we can launch Model Prep Split Solid Face. Select the blade face and make sure the method is set to wireframe. Now select the two split lines. The process of selecting wireframe located directly over a solid face has been vastly improved in Mastercam 2023. Previously, we would need to isolate the wireframe from the solid before we could select the wireframe. Our automatic splines don't fully divide the face into two pieces because the splines don't reach the edges of the solid face. Split solid face can do that for us if we toggle extend to edge. To see the resulting split solid face more clearly, we can use Model Prep Change Face Color. To split the other face of the blade, let's skip the wireframe creation and launch right into Split Solid Face. Select the remaining blade face. This time, let's use the Flowline Split method. Hover your mouse over the face to see which flowline direction is correct for the desired split. Select the location for the split and then repeat on the other side of the face. Now that our single surface blade has been split into two faces and two edges, programming will be easy. Launch Unified Multiaxis and select the provided lollipop tool. On the Cut Pattern page, select one of the large faces as machining geometry. Since we'd like to see flowline motion, choose the surface cut pattern. In the Style dropdown, choose a flowline option and click Apply. The flowlines here can run perpendicular to or parallel with the airflow direction. In this case, our customer requested cuts that are parallel to airflow. We can use Extend Trim to ensure our cuts extend past the edges of the blade. We can now complete this toolpath by applying familiar tool axis and collision control strategies. Thanks to Unified Multiaxis, we can now create multiaxis flow motion with more power than ever before.